I'm Brooke Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii. Welcome to Modern Wahine Hawaii. We're here at the beautiful Surfjack Hotel. I'm with Lynette Eastman, General Manager. Hi, Lynette.
Hey, how are you doing?
I'm good. Thank you so much. I feel cooler just walking into the property, like I'm at the cool kids table. Tell everybody a little bit about your background.
Well, I've been in the hotel industry now for about 30 plus years.
Okay.
I'm, of course, the General Manager of the Surfjack. Also, I am an on-air personality.
I knew the voice sounded familiar coming from the radio. So let's talk a little bit about the Surfjack, because it is like kind of not an inside secret, but it's kind of the cool place to be. What is the secret sauce about this property?
Well, I like to say that we're a small boutique hotel with a huge personality. And so we like to think we're that laid back, mid-century modern hotel that people can come to connect. So of course, you know, we have a beautiful restaurant, the Mahina and Sons, but simply it's a place, it's like a base camp,
right,
that you can come during your vacation, settle down, go out, come back, enjoy music, and just enjoy people.
I mean, the thing I liked about this hotel is that it's a wonderful, like some hotels feel like it's for tourists. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, whereas this sort of has a vibe of like a clubhouse feel, but like there, you could be a tourist or you could be a local. You don't know who you're sitting next to at the swim club pool.
Exactly.
They could be from Waipahu, they could be from Arizona. You don't know. We're all getting along. You know what I'm saying? So I really like that the vibe here is sort of like everyone's cool and mysterious, but you don't quite know their background, but you want to know their background kind of thing.
It is so funny that you touched on that, because Surfjack is really about the people. And so we like to say, love all, serve all.
Ah, I see, I see. And so what are some of the, you know, eccentric things that happen here on the property that you guys do?
Well, you know, what's exciting about how they designed the property, that mid-century look, is starting from the very beginning at the front desk. It's not your typical front desk. It's just a desk that's open, that our guest services agents come out, they mingle. Everything is about team effort here. I think that's the most important part.
Right, so when you're talking about, you know, being a part of the people, what have you, you guys have a very interesting, I don't know if you, what would you call him, like a mascot? Or is he like your guys' sort of like cheerleader?
Well, you know, as we went through the pandemic, we found a niche market that had dogs. And so after serving these dogs for over a year during that 2020, we decided to get a dog for the hotel.
Like the dog's the dog belongs to the hotel?
The dog belongs to the hotel.
Interesting.
In fact, when we opened in 2016, an owner back then said, hey, we should have our own dog. But, you know, I was like, oh, no way. But, you know, 2020 changed a lot of things. And I like to think of having something good that has come out of it. And so we have Jack, the hotel dog.
And he's the resident dog here.
He is the resident dog.
He runs this place.
He runs the roost.
Huh.
Yes,
and so
he does.
People can like hang out with him, or is he, what's his official capacity?
Well, you know, he's very, and you know, you can't tell when they're puppies,
Jack, right?
Right. Got him when he's 7.5 weeks. He was 7.5 pounds. Now he's almost 2 years old come October, and he's almost 50 pounds.
Aww.
But he loves people.
Right.
And we just got him into what we call preschool doggy daycare, because we're like, okay, well, he loves the people around the hotel. And because we have a lot of dogs, we want that socialization for him. But he's got a lot of energy. So he's kind of like his parents.
So people can bring their dogs to stay here as well. It's a dog-friendly hotel. Everyone's in the ohana, so everyone can bring, you bring your animal, you meet Jack, everybody's just kicking it by the pool. Is that sort of the vibe?
Look, we are the premier dog-friendly hotel
really?
In Hawaii.
Huh.
I think at any given time, on average, we've got 40 dogs in-house.
Really?
You know, it was wonderful during the pandemic when people, Kamaainas, you know, they wanted to get out because, you know, you could, you couldn't.
Yeah.
And when they did, they wanted to bring their loved one.
Right.
And so the Kamaainas know this is the place to be with your dog. Bring them on in.
Also, you know, another really special point about this hotel is you guys are very committed to sustainability. Because I even saw when I walked in, you guys have dispensers on the wall that give reef-safe sunscreen. It's like, we're not even going to wait for you to take up the Kuleana. We have it on our wall, so go get it over there.
Well, you know, it's been a few years now, right? I think the pandemic kind of slowed down the whole single-use plastic. And it has been just a wonderful thing. We hooked up with a wonderful vendor called Bird. They're really only in two hotels in the world. And it's just beautiful to have the bigger product instead of all these little products. Because every day we were putting that into the trash.
Yeah, and it adds up. It adds up.
It sure does. And so along with that, we decided, hey, well, let's bring in raw elements. Let's give an amenity to our guests that we have dispensers at the hotel.
Right.
And hey, it's reef.
Friendly.
It's reef friendly.
Right. That's amazing. Well, thank you so much for, you know, inviting us into your hale, if you will. That's amazing because, you know, a lot of people, dogs are their family. And when they want to go on vacation, you can't be relaxed because you're worried about what's happening with your baby at home. You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
so to be able to come into Waikiki, have a place to kind of relax and bring your best friend with you and not have to worry about crating them or putting them in some sort of a, you know, other hotel away from you. You wouldn't do that for your kid. Why would you have to do it for your fur baby, right? So that's awesome. But thank you so much for having us. I'm looking forward to talking to the whole team.
All right.
You guys are so much fun.
Thank you for coming.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Modern Wahine Hawaii here at the Surfjack. I'm here with Asami Sam Arita, who's the Vice President of Sales and Marketing. Hi, Sam.
Hi, Brooke.
I'm so excited to be here. We are in Mahina and Sons, just so people can kind of get an idea of what we're doing, where we're at. Tell people where you're from.
I am originally born and raised in Japan, and I moved to Hawaii for an opportunity to study travel industry management. So I am a graduate of University of Hawaii at Moana, the travel industry management.
Nice! So you're practically Kamaaina at this point. So here at the Surfjack / Swim Club, there's a lot of interesting sort of mix of events that go on here, right? Do you want to tell kind of people what the vibe is and what you guys are trying to create here?
Yes. You know, we do have all types of people, and then I think what's really special is that, you know, Waikiki or hotel just being labeled as the, you know, place for visitors, you know, but at the Surfjack, we have a lot of local people come in, you know, enjoy staycation or even attend our events or to dine at the, you know, Mahina and Sons restaurants. So we have a great mixture of visitor and the Kamaaina. And then, you know, I'm talking about what type of people, and then we have all ages, but you know, a lot of we were happy to have a lot of so-called Gen X people come in hanging out, but at the same time you have, you know, little older generation that come here with the family, three generation family, you know, especially for the Mahina Sons dining, it just perfect for the family dining as well too. So yeah, I have to say that we're a hotel for all people.
What are some of the like signature events that you guys do here?
Okay,
at
we have just so many, you know, signature event. But to start off, we have a big chill that it is a dance event. We have a DJ on set up inside the Mahina and Sons, and then we, you know, people will be dancing to the, you know, more oldie music, you know, and it's just a really nice environment in a contained restaurant environment, and then people just loves to come to that the event, and then also we have a Old School by the Pool. That's, I would say, one of the largest event that on the regular event that we have. You know, pretty much dancing to 70, 80, 90s music, and sometimes he's throwing 2Ks. And then it'll be done by the Swim Club. which swim club is around the area, in the lobby area, surrounding the pool. We have a cabana area that people just spread out and dance.
I was confused about the swim club because, you know, the hotel is a Surfjack and it's Surfjack and swim club. So can you kind of explain to people what the concept of the swim club is?
Well, swim club is where people just gather and meet and then, you know, mingle or relax or whatever. So it is our, you know, on the lobby level, it's just everything is focusing around our signature pool. You know about the pool,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And then on the writing of the wish you are here.
Right.
That pool has become one of the most Instagrammable shots.
It's very iconic.
Right. So during the event, of course, you know, everybody can attend the event. You know, some events we do have a cover, but you know, most of the time you can just come and, you know, join.
Uh-huh.
Hotel guests, you know, yes, the swim club is primary for the hotel guests.
Right.
Who can just enjoy, you know, during the stay and hang out at the pool and all that. You know, unfortunately, yes, you're a non-registered guest.
Yeah, you can't just come here and deep in the pool.
But our restaurant and the coffee shop, they're open to public. So they're welcome to, you know, dine or, you know.
And then do you have sort of some signature people that perform here regularly that are part of the Surfjack Ohana, like that perform here?
Yes. So we do have a nightly live music.
Every night?
Every night.
Okay.
And we partner with the Hawaii's Finest.
Nice.
So they do, you know, send us a very, very select famous local musicians, just to name a few. Kelly Boy Delima,
nice.
We love his music. He plays on Thursdays.
Uh-huh.
Then we have Jonah Couple plays as well, and then also Dustin Park. Those are one of the three, you know, top the
regulars.
And then we do also have like a Trisha Nale,
musicians. Where do they perform? Yeah. Are they in Mahina and Sons? Are they out by the pool?
They play at the cabana area, which is part of the swim club.
Uh-huh.
So everybody can just enjoy, not necessarily the, you know, restaurant guests.
Right.
You know, if you just want to hang at the pool as a hotel guest, they can enjoy or, you know, just sit in down their music.
Nice.
Right.
So now that I'm thinking about it, because when I talk to Lynette, it's kind of like there's a signature type of person, I guess. There's a personality, if you will, that comes to the Surfjack. Like, what would you say is like your typical personality type of client that comes through the doors here?
I would say, like, you know, people in, you know, 30, 40, you know, as far as the age group. We have, you know, a lot of all different types of guests and ages. But if you were to typical, there's people who just like to enjoy, you know, the relaxed environment, and then being a little bit more hip.
Right.
You know, you want to be somewhere special to be associated here.
Right. It does feel like a clubhouse.
Right.
It feels like less like a hotel and more like a secret clubhouse that you come to, and it's like a place you have to know about, you know, kind of a thing.
Right.
And then the fact that you guys are so dog friendly and that you guys have your own dog, I mean, that's some next level, like commitment to the cool factor. What is the one thing about that you love about the hotel?
You know, we're located right in the middle of
heart
hustle
of Waikiki.
And bustle of Waikiki, but when you put a foot into a Surfjack, it's just, you know, coming into that special place, the space just give you this sense of place. And you know, we really try hard to being really authentic Honolulu, mean that, you know, what you see is what you get. We're not like making things, you know, artificially pretend.
Right.
You know, things like that. I really, really like that really family Ohana environment that we create. And then also on top of that, right, in a really cool environment, you know.
Well, thank you so much for coming on the show and sharing all of those insider tips with us about the Surfjack. It really does feel like a home away from home in the middle of Waikiki, and you kind of need a secret password to get in. It's super, super cool. So thanks for being on the show today.
Yeah, thank you. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Modern Wahine Hawaii here in Mahina & Sons at Surfjack. I'm here with Lisa Tiny. Did I say it right?
Yes, you did.
Okay. She's the food and beverage manager here at Mahina & Sons. Hi, Lisa.
Aloha. How are you?
Or should we say kia ora na?
Kia ora.
See? So, I mean, I do it in a luau every now and then. Thank you for inviting us into your hale here. I'm very excited to talk about everything Mahina and Sons, because a little known secret, I came here once back in the day,
right?
But we're gonna talk about the new day, mm-hmm. because I'm very excited to talk about what some of the concepts you guys are doing here at Mahina and Sons and some of the different dishes you do. But before that, tell everybody where you're, you know, how you got here.
Well, you got some time? It's gonna take some time. So when I was in my 20s, I went on my OE from New Zealand, which is your overseas experience. Uh-huh. So I left for New Zealand for New York City. Most of us go to the UK.
Right.
But I decided to be different.
You took a left when they took a right.
Exactly. It's normally about a 2 years experience that you take because you can get a UK visa. But I decided to go to mine for New York. And 25 years later, I'm still on mine right now. So I was in New York and I was running amok. And I worked my way up through the restaurant and nightlife industry in New York, all the way to director of operations of 5 venues.
Wow.
So I ran 2 restaurants, 2 live music venues, and a 15,000 square foot nightclub.
So you've seen some things.
Oh, I've seen some things.
And so how did we get lucky enough to have you end up here on our island?
I wanted to get closer to home. And my husband, the Baza, Christian Tabe, he is from New York City. And I am from New Zealand, so Hawaii became our 50-yard line.
Ah, okay.
So it was only fair that we could be brown all year round.
Right.
And
that's a big commitment for New York, though. I mean, New York to Hawaii like, that's a full
stop. For me, it was okay.
Yeah, I mean, we're like New Zealand late. We're like New Zealand without snow.
Exactly.
But for him, from New York to come here.
It was a bit of a transition for him.
Yeah, he loved you. And so he works here at the property with you.
Yes, he came in as a consultant. And now he's the executive baza.
Okay, because that could be a little bit, that could go either way, especially when you come from New York. So what does a bar czar do exactly?
So he's technically a mixologist.
Okay.
He does not like that word, but that's why he is. So he creates all the cocktails. I taste them all and I approve them.
Oh, okay. So you're the boss.
Yes.
We have it now on tape. You are the boss. Let's talk a little bit about Mahina and Sons, because it's a very eclectic sort of vibe that this restaurant has, which is what I loved about it when I came. It's not your typical sort of sit down restaurant experience. It's got a little bit of an extra sort of joie de vivre, I guess you would say.
Yeah, we want everyone to experience something, a little bit of everything, whether you're dining up in our oasis or you're just down by our pool enjoying the music. We want everyone to enjoy the atmosphere that we are putting out. So we want everyone to feel like they're at home when they're dining here, and then when they leave, they just want to come back.
I mean, the food is amazing, first of all, but it's not served in a way where you feel like, this is amazing food, I really need to like act accordingly. It's very casual and sort of like elevated, but you feel like you're in your fancy mom's house.
Exactly.
But the food is delicious and it looks wonderful, but you still don't feel like I need to button up and like, you know, act a certain way.
You come as you are.
Right.
That's what we say. You want to feel formal, we'll put you somewhere nice. You want to feel casual, we'll put you by the pool, and that's how we'll do it.
So what's some of the flavor profiles that you guys are doing here?
Well, right now we're doing a range of flavors. So like we have a new dish called the chicken Milanese, which you know my to Chris, because he's Italian. So it's a pounded out chicken breaded with arugula salad on top. We do a little twist. Instead of using tomatoes, we use roasted grapes instead.
Oh, wow.
So that's another one that we're doing. We put our ribeye steak on. And then we also have our family feast, which is
That's a signature thing here, right? People come here to get that.
Yes, and
so
the locals love it.
What is that?
So it starts off with our crudo, and then you order your whole fish to however many are dining. So it could be 2, up to 6, up to 18, up to 25. So you just order your fish, and then it comes with the local sides, which is cucumber salad, pickled vegetables, roasted roots, hapa rice, and then our uala and kalo topped with the spicy mayo.
And it just all comes out. I mean, it's just like a big old luau
family feast.
Everybody just dives on
Everyone just digs in, and then we finish it with the signature banana pudding, which is a shout out to Chef Eric.
Nice.
And it's an homage to his mom.
Aww.
So that's a favorite of his.
Well, I've been talking to everybody today about what their sort of take is on Surfjack and what it is that, you know, drew you here, but what your sort of like underlying now, like what you feel about this hotel. So for you, what is that sort of underlying? What's the thing about this place that's so special to you?
That it's home. Like, we all work together, the whole hotel, the restaurant, we're all such a family that it just feels amazing. And we want all our clientele to feel the same way too.
Yeah, when I walked in here, you just don't feel like you're in like a hotel.
Right.
You feel like you're sort of in somebody's really nice house,
yes.
But that you don't feel like I can't touch anything.
Yeah.
It's just you get a vibe like, oh, I'm someplace that I'm gonna be okay. Like, it's, we're gonna have a great time.
This, yeah, we try to make sure that we can remember everybody's name, so then when we're out and about, we'll be like, hello, Mr. So-and-so.
Right, and
like,
right. And you guys have bikes and you have Jack, and there's just all of these, like, it's the little details, I feel like,
right,
that set a place apart, because there's so many hotels in Waikiki, let's be honest. There's tons of hotels, but there isn't a lot of vibe. And you guys really kind of bring something to the table.
Yeah, we thrive on the vibe.
Yeah,
so
you guys were like, you know, you may stay in a hotel, but when you come here, you're home.
Yeah, our pool's only little, but we make sure that you still have like enough to do when
right.
we're
and the here. Drinks are flowing.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much, Lisa, for coming on the show and for, you know, welcoming us into your hale. Say hello to the bazaar for us.
I will.
We're super excited about being here, and we wish you guys all the best. We're so glad that Waikiki's opening up, everything's opening back up, and that people can come back home. So thanks
Thank
for being
you.
Here.
Mahalo. Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Well, that's our show for today, Hawaii, here from the wonderful Surfjack and Swim Club. You need to come check it out because everybody here is so great. Come say hi to Lynette. Congratulations on her Pineapple Award from PVN. And thank you so much to Lisa and the Barzar and Asami, all of the wonderful staff here that's here to make you have the most authentic experience you can have here in Waikiki. This hotel is in the heart of Waikiki, but you'd never know it. As soon as you walk through those doors, it's like you're kind of at your cool friend's house, but you can have some drinks, you can have some wonderful food, you can meet Jack, who's the ambassador. He'll welcome you with lots of loves and kisses. So you can come and go to a night out if you want with the family, have some drinks by the bar, come in and have some wonderful food at Mahina and Sons, or just chill at one of the many events that they have there here, or come stay for a staycation, you know, Malahini, whether you're Kama'aina, it's all good here at the Surfjack. So make sure you check them out, and mahalo to all of them for reaching out to all of us. Remember, you know, we're on the other side of a pandemic. It's now called an endemic situation, but we're also gonna malama each other, and I'll see all of you next week.